To a lot of people out there, capoeira is the worst martial art there is. The movements are too complex, it's too low to the ground, unrealistic, too theatrical, it's just a dance. That is like the common perception of most people when it comes to the validity of capoeira.
I wanted to find out if these claims are true for myself. This is Juan Pablo, aka Peruca. He's a capoeira expert, and this is me, aka... I don't have a cool nickname. Anyway, the purpose of this video is going to be to test the validity of capoeira, and the only way to do that is to learn it, and then try it for myself and spar. Actually, before we go any further, I have a confession to make. This video should have been made a long time ago. In fact, the first time I tried capoeira, it was 2 years ago. In that video, I learned the basics. And I know you guys have a short attention span, so I'll kind of make this all a recap-a-weta.
Hey!
See, the initial way that you move is called a jinga. This is essentially the fighting stance of their martial art. They start off here with 1 foot back, they go to paralela, it's parallela. And then they go back and forth between stances in a rhythmic, circular motion. This creates a couple different types of evasive movements that they can use. They don't really have hard blocks for anything, they just don't want to be touched. Your mom can't relate. Heyo! Next, we went over some basic kicks. I'm gonna let him pronounce the name because it sounds much cooler when he says it.
Meia lua de frente. Okay. Half moon front.
It looks a little something like this, that's easy enough. Well, pretty quickly, things got harder. And then I found myself taking one of the classes, which was much harder. And that pretty much sums up anything that you might have missed if you hadn't seen the first video. But what I didn't really answer is why these movements look the way they do, why it looks like you're just kind of dancing.
When we talk about capoeira, we have to go and talk a little bit about the music, about the history. This was an art created by African Brazilians where the colonization of Brazil. It's not too different from the colonization here in the United States. Portuguese came to colonize. In that process, they bring people from Africa.
Yeah. It's a martial art came from the oppression. When the African people was doing the capoeira, they have to find a way to hide it, that they were learning how to attack and defend themselves.
Right.
How they hide it? The music.
The music.
And the movements.
And here we have the atabaque. Different rhythms depending on the birimbau is playing.
Okay.
So when they're in that movement, their speed and techniques are kind of dictated by the music that's playing. There's kind of like a mutual agreement in the music.
Yeah, it's depending on the music, how they're gonna play. In the African diaspora, it's all connected. Okay. And it's a huge movement that happens 60s, 70s with the b-boys and capoeiras in New York.
Yeah.
Because it's all connected, all come from the African diaspora. But capoeira, the name of capoeira, it was something that just happened in Brazil because of the situation of what's happening in Brazil.
Right.
And the pandeiro. Here in the US, the tambourine.
And now that we understand the reasoning behind capoeira and the purpose of hiding the true intention of the martial art, the question is still at hand. Can I make this work against people trying to beat me up?
Yeah.
Because the way that we move, we move in a circle. We're gonna practice the jinga, which is like pretty much some of the stepping, the standing of the kickboxing.
Right.
But you're gonna cross here.
Okay.
And then you're gonna cross to the other side.
Now, typically in any sort of kickboxing or really most martial arts, this would be a no-no, turning your back like this.
So the thing in capoeira, we always looking. So when I go here, I'm looking here, looking under my armpit, and here.
Okay.
With all of these evasive movements that we went over, there's a real emphasis on keeping an eye on the opponent and being able to throw strikes at unique and opportune times.
Ooh.
With the nature of having a style that is so based off of movement and rhythm, every kick, even the most basic ones like this roundhouse kick, can come from a more complicated angle, a more difficult to read place.
Boishinga. Go here.
Okay, that covers a lot of distance too.
Yeah.
And because the body really only moves so many ways and humans are really good at picking up patterns, we can give our opponent a pattern they think is gonna happen.
Here,
yeah.
Right.
Only for it to change.
I fake because my body, you know, my body's movement to this way.
Yeah.
I will fake and switch over here.
Ooh, okay.
So far, I'm liking this series of techniques that we've put together, but they all require a lot of space, which Muay Thai guys don't like to give.
So if somebody is like, sees me coming in and then they give me one of these, more like trying to squish me before I do something?
You have to go out of the range of the person. That's always in the movement. You go out, you switch, boom.
At this point, I'm just starting to realize how complex this is, because while maybe it seems like three or four steps, each one of those steps can have a stutter, a fake. It can switch where you can go forwards twice instead of just the same loop.
Yeah.
Well, you're doing the Jenga here, the footwork here, boom, boom.
And again, the style of capoeira shows me that this is a dance. This is predicated on movement and rhythm, but the crummy part for me, at least, is
same thing with the kick.
I can't dance. But luckily, I did notice a key feature in the capoeira movement.
And it seems like your feet are always somewhat connected with the ground if you're moving. Yeah. Like you're not like jumping up a bunch.
No.
You're kind of like sliding and gliding.
It's sliding.
Okay.
Because more connected to the feet I am, I can control more my speed.
Yeah.
And where I'm going to be and where I want to be.
And for me, that small detail, I felt like unlocked everything else.
Time the person will think that I'm doing here. Right?
Right.
So I will go.
Ooh.
Most of the rest of our session was remembering the old stuff we had worked on 2 years ago and then figuring out a way to use it for some trickeration.
Boom. The person will fake this way, right?
Right.
And then.
Boom.
We did finish up with him teaching me some faster stuff. Yeah. Thankfully, the man is very patient. Because a lot of it ended up just looking like this.
Here, do you put the hand
like that?
Here?
Yeah.
And then come up and in.
Yes, you jump. This one will sit out close here, and the other one will kick.
Cool. You make that look a lot easier than this.
Yikes. Yeah, I guess the next step would be for me to practice this on my own. Double yikes. I guess the next step then would be just to wing it?
I'm here about an hour early to film all of this. My goal for tonight, obviously, one, to make Juan Pablo proud, but two, I guess I want to really try and utilize a lot of side-to-side momentum.
I'm going to have to figure out how to threaten enough stuff with the kicks that I don't really have to rely on punches. I'm just realizing that I don't know if there's punches in capoeira. Oh, also, little fun, little silly bit of information. These guys are all very close to having a fight, which means they're in the part of training where they spar really hard.
I'm gonna make sure that the timing of my kicks isn't super obvious, because starting from such a far back position and then coming into kick, it's not really like an agreed upon spacing. And then the third thing is, I guess I'm kind of worried about all of the low kicks. The low kicks typically go to the legs, but if you are low, then the low kicks are kicking the high part of me.
So, meu birimbau, fai chi-chin-dong-dong, alegra minha alma, amenche meu coração.
Round one was interesting. It was interesting to say the least. I knew it would take me some time to get used to the rhythm and the movement of constantly being moving and being so low, but I think I focused a little bit too much on the movement and didn't really throw anything. I landed this, but that was pretty much the extent of it for the rest of the time. Everything else just kind of got stuffed. There's an example here of moving from the Jenga to the front kick, but because I wasn't much of a threat, I got punched. Quite a fair amount, which is, you know, it's fair. I did land the sweep, but other than that, I was kind of just smothered for the whole time, which is one of the things I was worried about.
Good job. Hands up. Your heart rate down. Keep your nose out of your mouth.
Straight up, in this moment, I felt defeated. I was exhausted. All I could really think about was how much energy I was using, but luckily I had a second to breathe. Oh, nope, we're into the second round. By round two, I still didn't really have much of the answer I was looking for. One of the only ways I'm going to be able to make this work is if I can start punishing him for coming in close. Okay, that was not the punishment I was looking for. More of this came for the rest of the round with one singular moment, a glimmer of hope. I'll take it. That's enough for me to work with. But something had to change in order for me to make this work. So I sadly sulk over to the bottom right corner of the frame and think about some of the wise words that Juan Pablo lent me.
The capoeira is moving all the time. It looks like it's something different. You know, it looks like they're not ready to attack. They're not trying to attack you or something. And that's when you see the kicks, it's the same. You don't expect it that the kick is coming.
Right.
You know, so yeah. When they are moving, boom, boom. Well, and then when the Portuguese come to see what were the African people in Brazil were doing, no, they're just dancing.
So I guess that's what I try and work for the next couple of rounds. Be a threat without looking like I'm a threat. Also, really quick, just while I've got you here, if you like my boxing gloves, they're Hayabusa T3 LX. Honestly, they're my favorite boxing gloves I've ever had. I am an ambassador, but I would say that anyway. The link is down below if you want them. Being lighter on my feet and a little less tense should hopefully get my energy back. And a little more energy means that I can try more things. I'm definitely not as low as I was before, which is probably why I'm able to move a bit better, because this is closer to what I'm used to. But I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing. If it's working better for me then, you know, it is what it is. My disappearing acts were a little less than desired, but anyway, there's one last piece of information that I think is going to really change how I spar with capoeira.
It's like every martial art, you do karate, and you understand, like, sometimes if you have a problem on the street, you're not going to go and do katas. No, you're going to go for the areas that you understand they are, like, for attack or defense.
Yeah.
Same in capoeira. If you have a problem on the street, you're not gonna start like just doing jinga, do cartwheels. No, you're gonna do one of those kicks and defend yourself.
Yeah.
Jiu-jitsu. You have a problem on the street, you don't gonna go pull guard and go on the floor. Yeah. Pow, they're gonna kick you in the face. So every martial art have their own area where you have to express that martial art. But when we talk about self-defense or real situation on the street, every martial art have that answer for that.
Yeah.
But it's just depending how you're gonna apply, how you're gonna do it. So that's why people sometimes judge the martial art, not the martial artist.
Yeah.
So it's two different things. When you judge, like, when you judge that, I know that art doesn't work. And if you have somebody who trains every day, it's very good in shape, a very good, ready to kick, ready to move, ready to do.
Yeah.
And you have another very efficient martial art, but the person doesn't train too much.
Right.
Which one you think is gonna which one gonna go over the other one?
Right. Yeah.
So it's not just the martial artist. The martial artist how they practice.
That was easily the most my body's had to work. 4 sparring rounds in a long time. My lower back is fried. I think all in all, it didn't go terribly. Like, that could have been much worse. Like, I know that these kicks can land, but the setups and the tactic behind being low and being kind of difficult and hard to figure out, that worked. Every single one of those guys in there was like, yeah, that was hard. Like, I didn't know what you were doing. I didn't know how to time it. I couldn't figure out what was coming next. But yeah, as much as maybe it didn't look like I was doing well, I think capoeira works. I think that's pretty easy to say.
It definitely a much richer history. It wasn't necessarily designed to like pit man against man. It was simultaneously expression while also like a community,
yep.
Right? Of people who were going through similar things.
Yeah, even when we do capoeira, we don't call sparring, or we don't, oh, let's fight, or let's, we say, let's play.
Right.
Play capoeira.